Hi, everybody. Glad you're with us today, and welcome to Ozarks Live. Good to have you here.
Howdy. Good to see you again.
Yeah, good to see you, too.
We had fun today.
Yes.
In the parking lot.
We did have some fun today.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got to tell you about something that happened. We kind of got a little jingle, jangle, jingle from Santa Claus out of the middle of nowhere, right? Very nice surprise. Some of Santa's elves actually showed up in the Colorton parking lot with a really nice early Christmas present. Take a look at this.
Don't believe you get squat.
All right, that was 12-year-old Kyrie Leninger and 13-year-old Max Duffy. They just stopped by to say thanks for being a friend to Springfield Little Theater. By the way, that was Todd Smith, our friend Todd Smith, on vocals. Did you notice that? I was listening to Santa singing that song, and I'm like, there's something.
No, that was Todd.
That was definitely Todd.
And he
was
very good.
He did a great job.
But
yeah, that was fun.
The elves were better this time.
The elves were fantastic,
weren't they?
I love when the surprises like that happen, and they call you up and say, what are you doing? Can you come outside for a second? Absolutely, I can. Yeah. Hey, did you and Cammie have a good time yesterday?
Yes, we had a very good time.
Good.
How about you?
Yeah, right? So I enjoyed that very much. I was out at Youngblood Nissan, and later in the show, we're going to announce who among the people who donated blood yesterday to CBCO were in the drawing, because they're giving away
to be
a car.
One of the finalists.
Mm-hmm. So every week, I think it's going to be every Monday henceforth that we tell you who the winner is. But here at the end of the show today, we're going to tell you among the donors yesterday who the winner was, who gets their name in the pot for that really cool little Nissan compact SUV. Nissan Kicks, it's really cool. I had a great time out there.
That's good.
Yeah.
You know, I saw something today that made me think, this might be end of times.
Oh, dear.
Yes. You know, Mike Tyson had a fight just the other night.
Mm-hmm.
When he's coming out to sign autographs, some guy actually, like, according to the story, took a swing at him, why won't you fight me, and reached into his waistband, didn't bring anything out, but Mike Tyson's group grabbed him and stopped him.
But I would think.
It's like, who in their right mind is going to take a swing at Mike Tyson? Something is wrong in the world when people start doing that out on the street.
So so the guy approaches.
Yeah, Tyson is leaving the arena.
Right, the guy approaches, says, why don't you fight me?
Why won't you fight me? Because it turns out he may have tried this before.
Well, this is a real good way to get him to fight you, I guess.
Well, Mike Tyson said, I won't fight you because it will end up badly for you.
Yes, I would imagine that it would. No, I hadn't heard that little bit of celebrity news.
Yeah.
Gosh, that ended in a draw, didn't it?
Yes, it did.
Yeah, I didn't see it, but I read about it.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. All right. Now you know. All right, we've got a great show for you guys today. Bruce Porter, of course, is going to join us in a little while for Dollars and Cents.
Plus, Cammie brings us another Ozarks Everyday Fitness. This time, she tries out silver sneakers.
Yeah, I always enjoy those segments from her. Not to mention our friends from APO are joining us a little bit later in the show because it is World AIDS Day.
Yeah, we have that and a lot more. But before we get to all that, here's what's on the radar. Okay. This is getting a little ridiculous. You remember that monolith found in the Utah desert we talked about last week?
The big silver thing
Yeah. Well, it disappeared.
Of course it did.
Yep. Yeah, that one there. After internet sleuths tracked down its location and people flocked to see it, it just upped and vanished. Still no idea as to how it got there, although there are some things out there that say, no, we know how it happened. Anyway. That's spooky, right? Well, how about this? About 4 or 5 days ago, another monolith, similar to the one in Utah, appeared in Romania. However, this one may not be quite as eerie. It seems the Romanian structure found on a protected archaeological site where a Dacian castle once stood was a prank, courtesy of a bad local welder. Yeah, it stood 9 feet tall, had intentional swirls and really poorly welded joints. But now, it has disappeared and nobody knows how. Yeah, all that remains is a small hole covered by rocky soil. Okay, come on, guys. Put a webcam or a Ring doorbell on these things. How tough can these be to keep track of?
I don't know, but I wonder if that is actually just a trick, you know, like it's about this tall, and they find some rocks, and they stick it in the ground. They go, oh, my God, this thing was 20 feet tall or whatever.
Oh, yeah. I mean, except, no. You'd be right if there was nothing to give comparison to size. But they had some pictures with people.
They did.
The Utah
allegedly.
One.
Allegedly.
Oh, there's that. See, that's the journalist in
you. I'm just a little skeptical of the whole thing.
I'm waiting to see. But anyway, you know, if one shows up in your backyard, take some selfies with it and send them in to us, you know, all in the interest of science. But, yeah, send us.
What did you say? It had intentional swirls and questionable joints. I have that, too, oddly.
I didn't think of that.
Yeah, so, you know. It runs in the family, I guess. I don't know. All right. I have a story about something tall, all right, something skinny, something shiny, showed up out of nowhere. It's starting to sound kind of like the same thing. But it had better not disappear, all right?
Okay.
If anybody messes with this, you're going to have to mess with me. You ready for a feel-good story?
Yeah.
Okay. An Indiana mom, Kalita Wheeler, came home one day from work, and she found something on her porch. She's like, what is that? Well, it was a brand-new basketball and a note. And when she read the note, she got a little bit teary, okay? Wheeler's son, Elijah Means, plays basketball outside all the time, and his setup was pretty beat up, okay? This caught the attention of a FedEx delivery driver named Aubrey Robinson. So Aubrey put up this brand new basketball hoop for the family. See, there's the new one and the old one. Now, when Elijah got home from school, he too was moved to tears. Aubrey said that she was so impressed to see mom and dad shooting hoops with their son when she'd drive through the mobile home park. She wanted to make sure that he had a hoop to grow up with. Apparently, went and bought it at a local Target store, spent about 6 hours putting it together, enlisted a friend with a pickup truck, took it over there, and was like, oh, they're not here. This is great. Set it down, write the note, put it on the porch.
That's a great delivery.
I thought that was great.
That is.
Yeah, and so I don't believe the two parties have met yet, but they do know who this driver is. They recognize the name. And apparently Aubrey went back and put some sandbags on it to make sure it wouldn't fall over
or anything.
It's just a random act of kindness that totally made me feel good. So don't anybody mess with that basketball goal. If that disappears.
Yeah.
I'm going to go all Mike Tyson.
I hope we see a video of a little one-on-one coming up with the driver. And yes,
that would be great. I know. Love that story.
Okay, now you know how much I like Guinness World Records.
Some, here we go again.
Yeah.
What have you found
some are
now?
Ridiculous, some dangerous, some absolutely worthless, but fun. This one, however, is something almost every one of us can relate to and feel to our core. I think this is a record set by the toughest people on the face of the earth and possibly the universe, known and unknown. Five Florida women now hold the Guinness World Record by collectively walking 2.04 miles in 1 hour barefoot over a pile of Legos.
Really?
Yes. Each woman had to complete a minimum of 20 laps on the 32.8-foot track. Of course, they cheated a bit. Turns out they are all professionals at Lego walking. You know, moms.
Yeah, that's all of us, right?
Yeah, the people who do this all the time. So congratulations to the champs. And just so everyone knows, medical professionals were on hand just in case.
That's, you know, anybody can make a record out of just about anything. But there's not a lot of people who can survive that. I don't think. That's a painful little jaunt they
took.
Not
me.
Nope, nope. I'm not going to go for that record.
It's been a long time since I've had little children in Legos. I still remember that pain.
Mm-hmm. It's not fun.
And some of the language, too.
Yeah, oh, yeah, I can still hear it. All right, coming up, it's another Dollars and Cents with Bruce Porter.
Don't go away. Ozarks Live is just getting started.